Well, when we started C2000 real-time controllers in the 1990s, it was really just specialty three-phase motor control applications that were looking to move from analog to digital, looking to take advantage of what we were making of this real-time controller, this integrated solution. Right? But since then, most three-phase motors have moved to digital control, and then a whole host of other power control electronics applications. So solar, server telecom rectifiers, all sorts of energy conversion, energy storage, and then of course what everyone's seeing is the electrification of vehicles, both on highway and off highway. So these applications have more complex topologies. They have a lot more requirements on the type of control loops, running more control loops, running them faster. And then you're also seeing a conversion from kind of our historical IGBT technology to running things like gallium nitride and silicon carbide. So the innovation over the years has come from a number of different areas. The first I'd point to is obviously CPU for performance. So when we first started, we were making a 16-bit processor that ran at 20 or 40 MIPS. And now we're talking about processors that have combined over 1,000 MIPS, right, of 32-bit floating point performance, often from up to like 5 CPUs. Right? So the amount of performance has really changed. The next area I would talk to you about is specialized accelerators. So we've added things like trigonometric math units, we've added parallel coprocessors that can be programmed, right, that can accelerate the math, that can portion the application into kind of separate parallel tasks, which has been important. And we also have specialized peripherals. So we've iterated things like our PWMs and our analog to digital controllers over the years. In fact, we're now designing our 7th generation PWM, which is adding more flexibility, and really it's built on all of the information and education that we've gotten from working together with customers in these applications to really know exactly what's needed and the capability of our devices, and to add one little thing each time to really make it the most advanced and do the exact job for these types of applications. We're proactively developing next generation reference designs. And oftentimes we're working with third parties or special consortiums who have expertise in this area, right? Really to bring the next generation cutting edge products to the market. So you're gonna start seeing functional safety spread to more applications. Similarly, you're gonna see the need for more security as things become more connected to the internet and to each other. You're going to obviously see the continuing need for more performance and features at lower price, so cost optimization of silicon resources. And then you're also going to be seeing more abstracted modeling, so working with our products from a higher level, looking at the entire system modeled and doing code generation through specialty tools instead of being necessarily down in the C code. And probably the biggest one that you're going to start seeing more of is artificial intelligence. So it gets a lot of, there's a lot of talk about artificial intelligence today in the market. It will apply even to things like motor controls and power supplies. And those sort of things will be deeply embedded into the application.